ApprovalMax allows setting multiple steps or level in the approval process. Each step is defined by approval rules that will guide the selection of approvers for this particular step. The approval rules are specified by an ApprovalMax administrator using the ApprovalMax functionality. The selection of approvers is typically based on data provided not only by the requester, such as costs, but also pulled from Xero, like suppliers, GL codes, accounts, tracking categories, and so on. Once the approval rules have been activated, all approvers in a step must approve in order for the request to move on to the next step. Here you can see a typical approval workflow, in this case bill approval, that includes three approval steps or levels. The organizational logic of these approval levels is that all bills must go through the initial level, department approval. However, only bills over 1,000 British pounds are subject to the next level, controller approval. And only bills over 5,000 British pounds will be routed to the highest level, CFO approval. Please note, although we are using bill approval as an example here, the same core functionality and setup process applies to other types of approval requests, such as purchase orders, sales invoices, credit notes, and other. ApprovalMax uses its approval matrix for setting up specific conditions for the selection of approvers in each approval step. The approval matrix allows using data from both the original request and pulled from the connected accounting system, for example Xero, to specify the conditions for each approver that can be selected in a particular approval step. In this example, data in the approval matrix that will serve as selection criteria either stem from the bill, like total amount, supplier, account, and so on, or are pulled from Xero, such as department. Let's take a look at how the ApprovalMax administrator has set up this particular approval metric. Lisa is responsible for all bills for the marketing department as long as they are over 200 British pounds. Nicholas is responsible for all bills over 500 British pounds. Willie is responsible for all bills for the sales department. Additionally, Willie is responsible for all bills for the G&A department. This means, for example, a bill with a total amount of over 500 British pounds for the department G&A will have to be approved by both Nicholas and Willie in order to proceed to the next step. However, if a bill is for the G&A department and its total is under 500 British pounds, then it will need only Willie's approval in order to proceed to the next step. Now, let's make the approval rules a little more complex. Let's say that all bills for the marketing department from a particular supplier, vendor ABC, need also Nicholas' approval. For this to happen, we need to add an additional approval condition for Nicholas. Then set the supplier to vendor ABC. Select marketing department. And finally press done to save these approval metric settings. Now, any incoming bills for the marketing department from the supplier vendor ABC will have to be approved by both Lisa and Nicholas. Please note, the data to be pulled from the connected accounting system, such as Xero, must have been set up in Xero beforehand, so that the ApprovalMax administrator is actually able to include it in the approval matrix. If, for example, you want to use a new supplier name or tracking category which has not yet been added to Xero, you can simply switch to Xero without closing ApprovalMax, create the respective data in Xero, go back to ApprovalMax and press the sync button. Alternatively, let ApprovalMax pick up the newly added data from Xero during the next synchronization, which usually occurs each couple hours. Click on Done to save the changes you made in the approval matrix. Now that the approval matrix for the department approval step has been configured, we add a 2-day deadline for the approvals in this step. When our deadline is reached, approvers will receive a reminder regarding the pending approval requests. Once you have set up your rules and approval metrics, do not forget to update the workflow, which will also save all changes. Questers are now able to submit their bills for proper approvals. Thank you for watching our tutorial on how to set up and configure an approval matrix in ApprovalMax. To learn more about ApprovalMax, please watch our other how-to videos.